A new reality show called Friday Night Tykes is generating controversy. The show follows a youth football league in Texas where 8- and 9-year-old children play tackle football. The program airs on the brand new Esquire cable channel. The kids are coached by often overzealous parents who berate, push, and even encourage aggression and violence on the field. The National Football League has denounced the program, calling it disturbing. Many health professionals say it is neither healthy, either physically or psychologically, for children involved.
Joining us now with more on this is family therapist and author Dr. Linda Mental. Linda, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
First of all, these kids in Friday Night Tykes are actually 8 and 9 years old. Are they a bit too young to be playing a physical contact sport like football?
Well, the big thing to think about with football, like a lot of contact sports, is the propensity towards concussion. When kids get hit, even though you have a helmet on, and this is what surprises parents, a helmet doesn't protect you from concussion. It helps protect the skull, but not from concussion. So these kids are just as much at risk for that, plus a lot of broken bones because of that too, especially when they're encouraging, which they are on the show, kids to hit them hard, hit them in the head, which not even the NFL does, and then hit their legs. And so we're seeing kids with concussions and broken bones, and that's dangerous.
Unbelievable. It's a little disturbing, actually, to see how intense some of the parents are forcing their kids to play. What are some of the consequences for forcing the kids to, you know, and being so hard on them?
I know, and one of the quotes I heard on one of the episode 2, I think it was, where the mom said, when the kids look bad, I look bad. Mm. And I'm thinking, this is so backwards. This is not about you as a parent. So putting that kind of pressure, when you force your child to play, and a lot of these kids, when they're interviewed, say they don't really want to play, but their parents are making them play at that level. And then what happens is the kids begin to build up a resentment. Later on, they might rebel because of that, and they just lose the enjoyment of doing something that should be enjoyable and should be building cooperation and all the good things we know that sports can do for children.
And is this unhealthy for them, parents, to put this type of pressure on the kids?
I really think it is, because it's really more about what your dream is as a parent. And I know I'm a dance mom, and so I know how that goes when you want your child to do the very best. But when you break that line of it's more about me and what I'm doing versus what that child needs, and if the child is actually having fun on this, then it does create a lot of tension in the parent-child bond as well.
Wow. What are the psychological consequences of being cursed at and being taught aggression at such a young age?
See, this is the thing that just blows my mind on this. So if you had somebody in a classroom, if you had a teacher cursing a child, humiliating a child, embarrassing a child, and this is what happens regularly on the show, you would call that person a bully. If it was a parent who was doing that in a family, you would say that that child was being emotionally abused. And so all the things that we see with bullying and emotional abuse are also potential problems for these kids. Problems with self-esteem, being anxious, feeling like they have to perform at a high level all the time, and worrying that they're failing and they're not meeting expectations, brings depression, anxiety, and in some severe cases, suicidal thoughts. So it's not a good thing to be doing what they're doing to these kids.
And it's reality TV, which means it happens in real life.
And I'm saying time out in the sporting event and rethink what you're doing to kids that are so young. One neuroscientist says that they shouldn't even be doing this before the age of 14 because of the impact on the body. So they really need to rethink if this is a good idea.
Well, Dr. Linda Mental, as always, your advice and your help is priceless.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.
Thanks.